Hi, I'm Joe with Family Handyman. A touchless faucet's a nice upgrade on any sink in your home. Here's one that you can install yourself, battery operated, no extra electrical wires needed. Let's get started. There are many different styles and brands of touchless faucets on the market today. They all have one thing in common. They need a power source to operate. This means you either need a 120 volt AC outlet under your sink to power the faucet or purchase a faucet that is battery operated. This American Standard Next Gen Selectronic touchless faucet has a 5-year battery life. You can also do an add-on battery pack that lasts 10 years. I'm going to swap out this faucet for the new touchless one. First, shut off the hot and cold water supply valves under the sink or shut off the main water valve for the whole house. Open the faucet to let any water drain out and leave the faucet open. Remove both hot and cold water supplies at the shutoff valves or at the faucet using an adjustable wrench. Have a bucket or container nearby to catch any water from the lines. Keep a towel on hand for this as well. Now it's time to remove the old faucet. Not all faucets mount to the sink the same way. Some faucets use a locking nut from underneath and thread to the shank of the faucet, while others have a threaded rod with a nut securing it to a mounting plate under the sink. At this point, it's a good idea to attach the supply lines to your faucet. This particular faucet comes with the lines already attached. All we have to do is drop it in. Next, we're going to secure the faucet to the sink. From the underside of the sink, assemble in this order: rubber washer, brass washer, and threaded lock nut washer with set screws. Hand tighten the threaded lock nut. Work your way around the lock nut, tightening the screws slightly each time until they're snug. Next, it's time to attach the supply lines, but first we want to add this one-way valve filter to the shutoff valve. Install the supply lines. Turn on both the hot and cold shutoff valves, then check for leaks near the filters and valves. Now it's time to test the faucet. We simply remove the protective film from the sensor eye. Wave your hands in front of the faucet. It should work. You can adjust the water temperature with the mixing valve lever. There you have it, all installed. Pretty simple, you can do this. It's just like swapping out a regular faucet. For more tips like this, visit us at familyhandyman.com.